Righto, so before we start, you'll see, got some new 33s on. Well, they're not new, they're secondhand. But 33 all-terrains, gone with the all-terrains, so I can go the long distance on these. Go to like TAFE and all that with these on, which is an hour drive up, an hour drive home. So they'll be quieter on the road, and I will have some other tyres for four-wheel drive, and hopefully some bigger ones when we put the lift in. But yeah. Basically, while we're going to replace these old ruddy mud flaps is, they're being held on by that bolt right there. Well, it's a screw, but anyway, yeah, that one screw there, and falling apart, and they just look bad. So we're going to cut our own out and put them on. Hopefully they look pretty good, and hopefully they work out on here. Here we go, one screw holding it on. Maybe I was wrong, but there's two. Oh, look at that, definitely secure. Or maybe not. Right, so to get our size, I'm basically just gonna measure from where it was last, which is basically the right size I want. So I'm just gonna pull this tape measure out one-handed. Drops the phone. Right, let me do that again. Okay, from end to end, it's about 430, so I think we'll cut ours at 440 and that will do us. The width is about 235, so I'm going to go 250 on these ones, and that will cover the length. So for my mud flaps, I'm going to use this really thick rubber here. You can use thin rubber, you can use these floor mats if you really wanted to. We might have to use them, might not, but I'm going to use this. So I'm going to cut a slice off because it's too heavy to lift. That's why it's in the toilet. So I'm going to cut off a strip that's big enough for both, and then we can cut it to the right size in the workshop. Righto, chop those flaps up. And what I've just done is I put a little curve because I'll make these sit out a little bit further on the guards than the old ones did, because got a tiny bit of tire poke there. Hopefully this will cover it up, and we'll do flares later in the week to cover that up even more. Right, so it's just down 50mm and just eyed it in there either side, won't really matter. And now we've got to figure out how to put these on there. Might have to tech screw it or something like that. So there we go. Righto, so with these mud flaps, what I'm thinking is to attach them, because these holes are so big. I mean, I could put little inserts in there, but I don't have them at the moment. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drill a hole in the flap, put basically a bolt through it, use a large washer on either side, and that should be enough to hold it up there till it settles in. It should be good. Might have to chain it up there one day or something. But we'll do that and see how it looks, and then we'll do the other side. Right, so mud flaps, back to the square one. I don't like the look of them. I put the lift in, they're too short, they're too skinny, and they're still curved. So, I'm gonna take them off, gone to Bunnings. I bought this mat for 10 bucks. Plenty of rubber, pretty flexible. I'm gonna use the back side as what you can see from the rear. So it should be all right. Now there's plenty of rubber there to make more than two mud flaps, but what we're gonna do is we're just gonna make two rears, and we're gonna make them longer, we're gonna make them wider, and we're gonna chain them up, hopefully to this tow bar or something underneath there, just to make them look kind of cool. So we'll get to that tonight, and hopefully we'll have some actually usable mud flaps, other than those useless things that are scraping on the tires. So let's get to it again. Try three. Righto, so because I've got this mat that isn't cut to size at all, what I've done is I've gone around about an inch or so, because that is the measurement of this side edge, and I don't want that showing on my mud flap, even though it will be the bit that gets mud on it, because I don't know, it just looks a bit dodgy and tacky, so may as well cut it off, make it look nice, and hopefully that will work, which it should because it's rubber. But yeah, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my size along here and draw it in, and then I'll cut it out. So the size is going to be 320 by 550, and hopefully those will be big enough to suit the car for what it does. So I'll draw that up and then we can cut it out. Righto, so that's two of the mud flaps drawn up. You can see I don't have much left. I thought I would have plenty left, but that's all I have. Now, this is one of the old mud flaps that I made. You can see it's much longer on the new one and much wider too, so that should be good. Hopefully that will cover the wheel, because this one doesn't. You can see it's too thin. If you're in the right angle, bit of tire poke is curved in, it hangs up too high, like there's plenty of ground there. Righto, so what I'm gonna do now is cut those out. She should be good to hang up. Okay, so both these mud flaps are cut out, all nice and good. I think I've changed my mind on which way I want to put it. I'm going to put it this way facing backwards rather than this way, just so it's easier to clean and it's easier to bolt it onto the actual car. So we'll do that using the existing bolt holes on what we did with the other ones, which were those three holes, and then a bit of wire through the corner to a bracket on the chassis. So we'll do that, mount them up, and then we can chain the bad boys up and see how they look, eh? Let's do that. We'll be right back. Okay, so I've just done one for the meantime. Just done those three bolts there on the, what do you call it, rear quarter panel. And then just a bolt there with some wire going to the exhaust mount there. That's just temporary for now. I'll put a better piece of wire there later. And I've only done one at the moment. I'll do the other later. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to chain up the mud flap from here up to this mount on the chassis. It's a good convenient spot, actually. Going to use some big washers and some bolts and this chain here, so it's pretty heavy duty, pretty overkill, but it'll look pretty cool going from there all the way up to here. So let's do that now. Okay, that's finished that one off. It's looking pretty mint, to be honest. I like it. Now all we've got to do is the other one. Shouldn't take long since I'm not filming the other one. I'll show you when they're both done. It's gonna look mint. Righto guys, so I actually finished those mud flaps and I either lost the footage to the end product or I didn't film. I can't actually remember because it was quite a while back and I'm editing this ahead of time. So just recently I went forward driving and both mud flaps ripped off. Not because they weren't chained up enough, because when I go forward driving I chain them up higher. It was just the rough corrugations and that they ripped out. So I am going to do another version pretty soon. They're probably going to be a bit beefier, thicker rubber, and the way I'm going to mount them is going to be a bit different. So look forward to watching that. And probably won't see that for a while, but just heads up on what's going to happen. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode of Outback Trekking. See ya.